And you talk about in your book too about, I don't know if you use the term radical acceptance, but I know part of the, I guess the physiology and the psychology really of somebody who's never considered anything could ever bad could ever happen to them versus someone who's considered it and prepared as much as they could, requires a radical acceptance of what's going on in the moment. And then also the will to act. Could you speak to that? What does that mean?
Sure. So you're talking about that section on how to become a hard target, right? Mm-hmm. So if you're, let's for our viewers and our listeners, you know, there's two types of the predator's optic is very binary. You're either a soft target or a hard target to them. So a soft target means you're a easy prey, low hanging fruit, not a lot of work to get from you what they want, victim, so to speak. If you're a hard target, well, they're going to have to work a lot harder for it, and they could get hurt or possibly killed. So, you know, those types of folks don't want to risk that injury or possibly death, especially if you're very well trained, and they can sense that. So the division of soft and hard is, here's the big difference. The delineator is those who are trained versus those who are not trained, you know? So if you want to be trained and you want to be a hard target, it would require three pieces to the puzzle. The first one is to expect, you know, adopt the idea that, hey, you know, right after this podcast, I'm going to go to, making this up, I'm going to go to the store down the street and I'm going to pick up a bag of ice or something like that. And you go down the street to the store and you expect, you know what, something could be a threat here and I expect that it could happen. Now, it probably won't. Odds are it won't. But just accepting the fact that something bad could happen to good people, i.e. you, and the folks that are with you, your protectees, just having that mindset that it could potentially happen puts you one step above the person who absolutely doesn't have a clue. The second thing is to have the will. Okay, let's say something does happen. Do you have the will to either get yourself and your protectees out of there or to manage that threat in another way? Because if you don't have the will to do that, it's never gonna happen. And then lastly, the third item is to have a plan. Let's say you're walking into that store and you walk into a firefight. You know, you hear the gunfire or whatever it is.
That's the iceberg.
You know, you turn right around, go right back into your car. you know, you've avoided all that, right? So those are the three things. Again, adopt the fact that bad things do happen to good people and it could happen to you, and not some far off date, you know, in the imaginary future, but right now, the split second you walk into that store. Mm-hmm. The second item again is have the will. If you need to, and it might be stop the threat, or it might be get you and your protectees off the X. And then lastly, have a plan. Okay, if I walk in there and it's really bad, I'm just going to turn around, go to the driver's side, open the door and exit.
Mm-hmm.